It doesn't look that complicated, this collection of hardware store materials, but it may represent a breakthrough in cleaning up polluted water near coal mines. Even more compelling, this device is actually a revived 16th century technology that uses no electricity and requires little maintenance. Call it simple and sustainable. This is a Trompe.
Water comes in here and falls down this vertical pipe. At the same time, air is entrained, and the velocity of the water carries the air bubbles down to the bottom here, where we change direction and the pipe enlarges. The water bubbles then float to the top and are captured in these reservoirs. The bulk of the air is captured in the first one, and the remnants are captured in the second. Then the water without air comes out the discharge pipe and is discharged here.
In turn, the bubbling air oxidizes the iron in the water, which then settles out, leaving the water clean. Levitt first encountered a 1910-era Trompe, the largest known in the world, in the 1970s as an engineering student.
We were on a trip in Canada, driving past the Ragged Chutes air compressor, and they pointed out of the bus and said, yeah, they use falling water to compress the air, and they use the air from that compressor to run the rock drills in the mines of Cobalt, Ontario.
But the Trompe's history goes back to the 1600s, when ancient engineers realized that falling water could capture and compress air and make it usable. Later on, Spanish engineers refined the process for iron forging. In 2010, OSM issued a call for proposals for ideas on how to clean up polluted mine water, preferably off the electric grid at lower cost and with the potential for wide use. That's when Levitt remembered his visit in the 70s.
It was largely a forgotten technology, because once electricity came along, the need for this kind of an air compressor disappeared because it's not mobile.
The irony is, the same reason people abandon using Trompes is why it's attractive for use here. It doesn't need electricity or any other power, just water and gravity.
And the first time we read the proposal, it was just awesome. I mean, it was well received, it was innovative, it was simple, and it was applicable to many regions of across our country that have these types of issues, this mine drainage issues. So it fit many categories for us.
Better yet, the materials needed to build a Trompe are all off the shelf, ready to use.
You can buy most of the parts at Home Depot.
As a result, Levitt succeeded in winning an Applied Sciences grant from OSM to begin developing the device. But then another problem arose, a big one.
Just about 2 years ago in July, I was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer.
To keep things moving, Levitt asked several nonprofit and commercial groups to step in and handle the heavier lifting. In the meantime, he faced surgeries and chemotherapy and a long recovery.
Took a bunch of pieces parts out, and so far we're optimistic.
In March, the full-scale Trompe went online, moving compressed bubbling air into polluted mine water. While it may look like the opposite is happening, the rusty coloration means the air is oxidizing the iron. In other words, it's removing it.
Iron's oxidizing in the cup.
Now with the proof of concept underway and early results promising, Levitt hopes to offer Trompe design and development to other mining and clean water groups.
I think our watershed groups are going to love it, the nonprofit groups that spend their time and money to develop passive treatment systems. I think it's going to work for the abandoned mine land sites where our states go in to do priority projects. And I think it's potentially good for industry. Then industry is going to be able to use it to further develop their treatment systems.
It's the kind of innovation that OSM seeks and sponsors in its mission to protect people and the environment. For the U.S. Department of the Interior and the Office of Surface Mining, Reclamation and Enforcement, I'm Chris Holmes.